Well, the wonderful view of the Ellis Park precinct as the crowd start pouring into the situation here at Emirates Park when the stadium is full. It's absolutely fabulous. The Xerox Golden Lions against DHL Western Province, a repeat of last year's final where Western Province won by 19 points to 16. And so we await the players on this. If you saw me doing the pitch report, it is extremely warm here in Johannesburg. We really need some rain. The field is very hard underfoot, although the surface is absolutely fabulous. And those are the moments. Eight of those players played last year in the Currie Cup final. And in the Lions situation, 10 of them played in the APSA Currie Cup final. Job Dobson, the coach, has gone for the same front row. Wilco Lowe, who played for South African under 20, Mbonambi Kutsoff, a very workmanlike and talented front row. They're young, but they're very talented. Buerta and Klein, both really Gauteng boys who have moved down to the Cape. Notchek, Carr and Elstad provide the back three. At halfback, Nick Groom playing in his fourth final this afternoon, along with Robert Dupria, whose dad played in five finals. Kortse and De Jong. Kortse also an East Rand lad, and De Jong the captain. Leitz, Colby and Sonatla. Sonatla and Colby played in last year's final, and Dylan Leitz playing in his first final. There we have the bench. Michael Willemsup, Ollie Kebble, who has been around for a while. His dad, Guy, played in four finals. Jano Vermaak, who's the most experienced player amongst the 46 on show today, if they all are on show. 44, I beg your pardon. We keep thinking they're 23, but they're 22 in an APSA Currie Cup side. So the Lions, a very impressive season that they've had this year, unbeaten in the APSA Currie Cup. And you can see the wonderful surface now. Johan Ackermann has made a change in the front row, where Robbie Kutsia starts ahead of Malcolm Marks. Riedling has two tests to his name. And then Franco Mostert and Erasmus. Lawrence Erasmus, who's come on in leaps and bounds, just 21 years old. The other change is Quagga Smith coming in. Very interesting. Quagga Smith, lighter in stature, but rapid around the field. Marnus Borsoff and Ross Krinier. Ross Krinier played in his third final this afternoon, won for the Sharks a couple of years ago. Jansa van Rensburg comes into the side, the young lad who weighs over 100 kgs, and then Skwasan Kutsia and Folmink, Anthony Folmink, who's come into the side quite recently, but provides a lot of pace down that left flank. Malcolm Marks reverses the bench. Ruan Dreyer, Boyson, Devitt. The Vitt also played in the semi-final last week. Van der Walt played in last year's final at fullback, and Storky Sanakom reverts down to the bench, with Sampi Mastriet being the final man in that 22 party. So, Warren Brosnahan, we've had time to soak it up. Rudolf Strelly told me there were 38,000 tickets sold. 40,000, he reckons, should be here. This is the atmosphere. You played in three finals.
Oh, man, it's just an unbelievable experience for these players. The nerves are going through those bodies right now. This is what you play the game for. You want to be able to measure yourself and play in this APSA Currie Cup competition and play in the final. This is many players, many great Springboks haven't had this opportunity. These players are going to get this opportunity. We spoke to Stephen Kitsoff before, and what a great season he has had. His impact on this game is going to be immense. This Western Province side has got a very physical edge about it at forward time. Some big guys, Wilco Lowe, over 130 kgs, Buerta, Klein, big lock forwards, and a very combative loose forward trio. It's going to be an interesting tussle between these two rivals.
Yeah, and the Lions will underestimate Western Province. They've got to forget about the 70 points they put on them in the playoff, not in the playoffs, in the round robin, and just concentrate on this game. I saw Swage de Brand, the assistant coach, backline coach. He said, I hate being the favorite. I like to be the underdog. So Johan de Jong, also the captain of the Western Province side, who playing in his fifth final this afternoon. So there he comes, the cheerleader. They come down the steepish passage there, then onto a red carpet, and the truck begins. The truck begins, and the roar will begin as well.
That's a unique experience for a rugby player running out here at Emirates Airline Park. We spoke about the forwards for Western Province. Their back three, their backs are electric. They've got the X factor throughout that side.
Lots of Western Province supporters here, as we would expect in cosmopolitan Johannesburg. There are province jerseys all around, and Stephen Kutsoff, who will be playing his 33rd Absa Curry Cup game this afternoon. I had a quick chat with him earlier on. What a likable young man. Jason Colby playing in his third final. So many of these players have represented South Africa at under 20 level, and the roar starts to build for the Lions to welcome Jaco Kriel. We have to remember that Jaco Kriel is captain. We get so used to Warren Whiteley leading the side out, but it's Jaco Kriel who took over the captaincy and has maintained it when Warren Whiteley came back from the Springbok camp. So it will be the live wire Flankford, followed by Jacques van Rooyen, who's come on in leaps and bounds since playing Varsity Shield rugby a couple of years ago. And the young lads, what a moment for them. What a moment. They're building now as they're just about to emerge out onto the field. Let's hear the roar for the Lions.
Oh, what a feeling, I tell you. The adrenaline is coursing through the veins of all these players. This guy here, Jaco Kriel, what a try he scored last week. He has been absolutely sensational. He had a great year last year. He's having an even better year this year in 2015. Robbie Kutsia has been good as well. It's been a very solid forward pack, isn't it?
Well, the players line up for the national anthem. Warren Whiteley, who puts in so many tackles in Curry Cup rugby. And it will be Lloyd Pele who will sing our national anthem. Fabulous rendition of our national anthem. And so the Lions supporters are plenty here. There's plenty of red. There's fabulous scenes here. That's the Curry Cup rugby. Western Province have won the Curry Cup 33 times, the Golden Lions 10 times. And Western Province, who won it in the early years, the time in and time out, and hasn't been all their own. You have sideline commentary. Let's hear from the Gibbani Bobo.
Oh, it's Bedlam out here, Hugh Bladen. It's amazing atmosphere. How good it is to see Rasta Rashivanga calling up his first Curry Cup final. But it's just the excitement. Speaking to Paul Trier, and you can see the TMO. That is Maurice Yonker, who'll be looking after those decisions, which everyone will want to be out on AVM for those decisions. But what an atmosphere. And all the Joburg has come out, and there's a few splatter of blue and white that is in the crowd. But looking forward to see how these two teams take on this challenge.
So Rasta Rashivanga, the youngest Curry Cup referee ever at age 29, could see it. In fact, it's Quaco Smith who burst away with the ball. Trinia. Now the Lions, as they want to run the ball in their own 22 via Franco Mostert. Trinia now could see it with his preferred left boot.
Now immediately, the Golden Lions show, and they play like they played throughout the Curry Cup. They're prepared to give a bit of width, open up that angle so that they can find some touch, and it's a nice little start there for the Golden Lions. That'll settle the nerves.
Rasta Rashivanga will be assisted by Stuart Berry and Jason Yafta.
Open at the back wide.
Bongi and Banambi. They have two-meter tall locks, as Warren was saying. And also Reinhard Elstadt that they use quite liberally, but the Lions trying to interfere with that ball. Looks like Mostert may have stolen it. Cronier, Whiteley up to the halfway line. A great roar from the crowd. Now it's a Jaco Kriel. You've got a Jaco Kriel and Quaco Smith who are so similar in size. I like the ball on the bounce. The ball on the bounce quite often can be a situation which puts a man just around somebody. And now it's Van Rooyen over the 22 of Western Province. Quaco Smith in there, but Cronier gets. Now it's Borsoff away for Yedling Hacks. That's a wonderful little grubber. But it's grabbed by the Stephen Kutsoff. Great defensive work by the loose head prop. If he can get that back, well, the Golden Lions get a penalty. Could have well been holding on there as Kutsoff. Well, I mean, he made a timeless entry into the play, did Stephen Kutsoff. So now it is decision time for Jaco Kriel. I'm sure he'll get a little bit of advice from Warren Whiteley.
Moritz Borsoff has stepped forward. They're going to go for the drive. And the positive intent is clear for all to see.
That was the line-out steal, bros.
Superb work there by Lawrence Erasmussen. Gobani, the intensity that the Lions have started with, they've got over the advantage line, they're breaking the tackles, and they're exposing a few little defensive holes in Western Province early.
So what is different for me, Warren, is the fact that now they're starting to be more direct at the carries. They're getting all the advantage line with the players like Jaco Kriel, and you can see that's the intent. It's all about making sure that they up their tempo, up the pace. And this side is a young side, this Western Province team, and they're at altitude. So you want to use that first 20 minutes, make sure that they're chasing shadows.
Stephen Kutsoff has received some attention, but seems to have recovered. And they're battling to catch their own ball of these forwards. Nick Groom at halfback is feeding it up to Noche. Former Weinberg scholar who's had an outstanding season. Robert Dupriere coming to the side a little bit later. That's good play by Western Province.
No last form first. Very well done by Western Province at the line out. They compete, they get up. Okay. The Lions would have been banking on getting this ball.
That guy enters the way you're attacking the breakdown.
But that compete is fantastic. Yep. Yeah, that is good by Vuitta.
Thanks, Benner.
Getting very, very high. And then the regrouping from the Lions is also good to hold this up and force the maul. Once this goes down, they don't have to roll away.
Well, we have the first scrum of the match, and the Lions have prided themselves right throughout their season on their tower at scrum time. Let's have a look at those tack weights. 8.55 against 9.10 for Western Province. It's So they have a slight weight advantage there. Okay, but they too have an experienced tight five.
Bind. Set.
Julian Riedlinghaus, the tight head prop.
Let's go, Sandra.
Remember, it's hard underfoot. You've got to have the right boots on here.
It's a real matchup there on that far side between Kitsoff and Riedlinghaus. And that's where it goes down on the opposite side. And it's going to be a real good matchup. Kitsoff is in the form of his life at the moment. Getting around the field, contributing with ball in hand. He's a very strong scrummager. But Julian Riedlinghaus is very strong in that tight head position.
Stephen Kitsoff also playing in his third final this afternoon. Western Province in their fourth consecutive APSA Curry Cup final, champions last year. A game in which Stephen Kitsoff, in fact, did not play.
Set.
So coming slowly for Crinier, Borsoff had to reach. Now it's Fulmunk. Up to the 5 meter line. Crinier's there. Moster drives for the line. Cronier has to dig again. It goes to Robbie Kutsia. You can see right in front of the post. And, well, a little bit of a mix-up there, but eventually it's fullback Kutsia who gathers the ball in. Advantage. Help from Whiteley. Advantage.
Leave it.
Now, it'll be interesting to see. Surely, Bros, they will kick for goal. Surely.
Yeah, they've got to. You've got to take those points when they're on offer. You can't walk away and not take them, and that is the decision that they have made. There's a scrum. Getting a little lateral there from Kitsoff, and then it was held up here by Western Province, and they slow the ball down. That's the penalty. A lovely camera angle there from the crossbar on the uprights.
Well, that 94% kicking average means nothing as long as Borsoff, he missed that kick. Oh, man, it's Borsoff.
Wow.
It just means nothing. It's now a final. It's a different story.
Hopes, take us through this one.
Oh, you take it through this one. Just the way that he just wanted to drill it through the post. You can see he keeps his head down, but actually he didn't have the direction. It's unbelievable from him.
Borsoff in action again. Not going quite as far as he would have wanted. And the tap down is, I think, by a Province player, by a Lions player. And so Jason Yufta has his flag up in favour of Western Province.
Of course, you remember that final from last year where Borsoff missed a couple of kicks, and you wonder if that memory is lingering in his brain. He's got to clear it and forget about it. But there were two plays there, the kick and that up and under, which were a bit shaky from Borsoff.
Good clean line out ball. Groom away for Dupria. Step on the inside is good. Groom again, now Mbanambi. Kitsoff stopped initially by Kutsia and by Whiteley, on the bounce by Noche. Groom, Carr getting it away to Dupria. Good quick defense. Howard Manisi making the tackle there on the very tall lock forward. Groom again, Kitsoff, Dupria reading the play very well indeed. Got it away to Dylan Lates. First touch of the game for the winger. Now the driving play there by Anthony Fulmunk.
Turnover's good.
Turnover is good, and it's picked up on the Fulmunk who goes away. Now Van Rooyen, the winger at half back. Yaku Creel. Cronier had to get there very quickly. Borsoff away for Mostert. Always will the drive, but Nochi did a good defensive block there. Now it's Erasmus. He's got long strides, as 2 meter tall lock forward.
Vinek's not by the last feet.
Just getting away from Sinatra there. And then it's Notchy.
Not by the last feet.
Now, if I were the skipper, I would give Borsoff another kick at goal
not
here.
By the last
feet. Oh, that's a definite there, Hugh. They have to make sure that they build the confidence off one, it's Borsoff, and they have to collect the points because they had the pressure. So now it's time to convert that pressure and 2 points.
Well done, Yaku Creel there. Because it's not such a pressure kick. I mean, it's not a gimme.
Yeah.
And so he can just relax and have a shot at goal. There's a little bit of a swirly wind here in Johannesburg.
This is the tackle from Howard Onesi. It was a great one. He got the shoulder in. The technique is absolutely perfect. Got in under the ball.
Just latching on to that, Braz. See how he's leading with the shoulder, and that leg is coming up with that shoulder. In that way, he's in a strong position on the big man, and he dipped himself, working out from an upwards motion.
Now the ball is flying just wide again. He's not making bad contact, but just not getting it quite right at the moment.
Had a slow start at the beginning of this game. He was trying to use the wind to carry the ball over so he can push him in the midfield. And missing out on that one.
Well, it's Borsoff again. He will go for the hoist. That's a lot better one. And Robert Dupriere is underneath it. Mostert gives chase. Mostert can't grab the ankle. Now it's Colby. Always a buzz of excitement when he gets the ball. But he's slight of build is Colby, so gets muscle to ground. Notchy gets it away to Dupriere. Could see it. Back for it is Dupriere. And taking the mark. Gets it away to Colby, who can be dangerous in the situation. Decides to go with the boot and boots it straight into touch.
Oh, an error from Cheslin Colby. John Dobson last year this time. He was coaching the under-21s in the final that they played against the Bulls under-21 team. Today, it's the seniors.
It's not a great memory for him. That's when he lost last year. Jason Greer scoring a try in the last few minutes of that game. So John Dobson will be looking for a better, I guess, the result in the final.
Well, John Dobson's dad, Paul, wrote a wonderful history of the Curry Cup on their Rugby 365 website. Now it's Whiteley, good ball in for Creel. Away by Cronier, now Borsoff on the switch there for Jansen van Rensburg. Cronier, Riedling Hayes. Province pride themselves on their defense. Cronier couldn't get it away. Colby with a little sidestep, then the boot away. And that's a lot better by the fullback as Spassan has to race back. So a huge amount of ground won by Cheslin Colby.
Oh, he's absolutely superb in that impulsive moment when he doesn't have to think too much. He just works purely on instinct, and that's what that kick was there. Superb from Colby.
So far, Province have made 17 tackles against the 8 of the Golden Lions, and they've all been pretty good. They've made 19, in fact, and missed but 2. So Robbie Kutsia with this throw that becomes important. Well taken by Whiteley.
You reckon we blow it?
Good burst away by Kutsia. Cronier for Creel. Now Borsoff making some ground. And look at this. Bursting through the tackle goes Jansen van Rensburg. Looking around. Oh, he held on too long. But a beautiful bit of following up by Kutsia, the fullback. Cronier should commit runners here. To the ball, they're well inside the Western Province 22 now. Borsoff waiting for Whiteley. The step and go! Whiteley!
Markham and Swaes De Bruyne very happy with their charges. It's all about that break from Ryan Janssen van Rensburg. He's big, he's strong. He played in the Junior World Cup back in 2012. He muscles his way through. He's over 105 kgs, is Janssen van Rensburg. And then it was the wide ball, and there was no defense inside for Western Province. Well spotted and well played by Waki.
Look at the physicality from the Lions. This is what they're all about. And they thought that they're going to come here and dominate physically. Could not see that. Bad tackle technique there from Cheslin Colby. But Cronier does so well. Look at this. Just making sure that they play a direct game. Attack in the space. Name of the game for the Lions.
Great roar from the crowd as Marlos Borsoff kicks his first successful place kick.
Oh, what work here. Making sure that over the advantage line was the Lions, and then Marlos Borsoff, knowing that his captain's on the inside, giving a bit of verbal too, gets it. That's what there is. Super Rugby captain Warren Whiteley, one of the leaders of the side.
Dupriere. Smith. Good safe tackle there by, amongst others, Nizam Carr. That's not a bad little kick ahead of Mostert. Very nearly got it, but the province have tidied this up quite nicely. Have they got enough runners? Dupriere goes against Erasmus, gets it away to Colby. Need a half back. Elstad trying to go through the middle. Colby now does the job at halfback.
No, play off.
Carr. Not chip. Groom. Johnny Kotsa. Difficult to bring down. He's a big lad, Johnny Kotsa. Now Groom gets it away again. The tight forwards having a little rumble forward.
Eight offside. Penalty advantage.
Warren Whiteley offside, the referee says, and so Province. Offside. Now, what will Province decide to do?
Yeah, go sort it out.
Robert Dupriere, who's coming, playing just his ninth game in Absa Curry Cup, a debutante this season. Is entrusted with the place kick.
He's had a fantastic season. I tell you, you've got to go all the way back with this play of the ball. That guy there handling the ball now, Nick Groom, did so well with that little kick to collect that ball for Western Province and save the situation. He showed tremendous bravery and courage to the little scrum half.
Right behind me, the grandstand is chock-a-block. You can see from the shots. Unbelievable, the people that have come out to support this Curry Cup final 2015.
Well, what a day it is for South African rugby. The Curry Cup final and then the semi-final of the World Cup. Good looking strike, but that swerves away. There's a little bit of a wind factor down there, bro.
Definitely, when we got here this morning, the wind was blowing, and it's obviously having an effect. Robert Dupriere looked on anxiously, urging that ball to swing in. It didn't.
Yeah, it swung out.
He had the away swinger.
Chance here for Carp.
Mostert works hard.
Very hard. Now Notchet. Groom. Dupriere. Colby. Spassan had to hold his line there. Colby running into Smith. Smith could... No, it comes for Nick Groom. That's good play by Colby.
Hey, Stuart,
now
are you happy with space there?
Grabbed by Riedling Hayes. Groom again, Dupriere, not yet. Dylan Lates is out wide, but it comes forward, Dupriere. Sinatra. Very nearly away, the winger, but he's well tackled. Worked up for Kotze again. Very physical game it is. Elstadt is in the thick of things there. Now worked away by Buerta, then Dupria. Wilco Lowe, who won his South African under 20 colours when playing for the Blue Bulls. Turnover, yeah. Oh, Rasmus nearly slipped on the inside. Mostert couldn't get the pass up. Picked up by Rasmus again. Not a bad little ball over the top there for Kutsia. Kutsia still going. Somebody's got a bit of cloth. It comes for Fulmink. And then away it's Rastrenier, who gets his first try of the AFSA Currie Cup season. And what a timeliest one it is for the home side.
Well, you've got to admire this Golden Lions team. They've come in here in the Currie Cup final with all the pressure and all that's involved with that, and they've just stuck to their game plan. They've stuck to what works for them. They've used their forwards. This guy here, a couple weeks ago, he's making his debut against the Sharks. Right now, he's playing in a Currie Cup final, and he's having the game of his life. But Kutsia does so well, powers his way through forward. And then it's the awareness of where the defence is. The little offload inside was absolutely perfect. There was no one home for Western Province. Great try by the Golden Lions.
Just tell Philip, we're not going to have a water break because they just took one now with the try.
Yeah. Well, you probably heard the referee quite clearly now that they won't have a water break.
Oh, what a work from Fulmink and then Ross Cronier just backing up the player. That's how they recycle themselves to give themselves a better chance to support the play and influence the game, the Lions, and they've just been so physical. Lawrence Fenter, take a bow. Rasmus back, pardon.
Well, it's twice that the Golden Lions have found that little inside channel. Once with Whiteley, once with Cronier. Focke-Smith very nearly dropping that ball, but recovered well. Cronier gets through a lot of ground in a match. Backing behind his forwards. Mostert. See the ground that Ross Cronier had to make there. About 30 metres to get behind his forwards. Work for Dupria. Now for Colby. Just sizing up the opposition and then accelerates away. Well, look at where Lawrence Erasmus chucked his man down. He was beaten by Colby initially and got back. Great work by the young lock forward. Groom, Dupria. Not too much space there for De Jong. Coming for Kutsoff.
Powerful.
Now, clean out's good there. I'm happy with the clean out.
Dupria, but it's a pretty static sort of ball here. Now Sinatra changes that.
No, not down the last seat. Advantage. Penalty advantage.
Vossoff was offside, so they are on a penalty advantage here. Our Western Province. They need to get some points on the board, do the visiting side. Groom, Dupria. Little barge forward there by Elstad. So there's no advantage. They will go back for the penalty. Marnitz Borsov got himself into no man's land. That's Nick Groom, in fact, who stayed down.
Offside.
He's taken some heavy contact as Nick Groom. He's put his body on the line. Wouldn't expect anything else in a Currie Cup finals. Siavela Sonantla, the man who hands that ball over to Robert Dupree, and they're going to go for the drive. They're going to try to get that working.
Overcooked.
Dobson looks on.
I think he's missed touch.
Overcooked that.
He's missed the touch.
That is a terrible mistake.
Oh, you can see that reaction from the coaching staff. They really need to make sure that they get any. If they get any opportunity inside the half, you can see this kick here. It's a bit off of it.
And the thing is, Bobes, he's walked all of 25 metres to kick that ball. I mean, Sinatra could have just kicked it. He only had to go 5 metres.
Oh, yeah, you didn't have to take him into that further.
So the drop out is taken by Reinhard Elstadt. Krug. Now the little burst from the lock forwards, Dumbanambi now. It was Buerta who made the initial run. Dupria, you see that? I just don't think they're getting any momentum going forward. Another penalty. It was Jakub Kiel who was warned by the referee. Now this one is straight out in front of the post.
And in finals rugby, you've got to think, take
your
those
knees
3 points.
Your everything is on the deck. I can't reward you.
Chisel away at that lead.
Looks like they're going for touch.
I don't think they're going to do that, Cobbs.
They're going for touch. They already set themselves up. They're going for touch. They're already chasing the game before they end. The game is away from them, and they still got a half where they can still pile up the points. I guess the 14 points that the Lions have is really chasing them. It's putting lots of pressure. Competing on the breakdown. He was told that it was already a ruck and he's not supporting his body fit or supporting his body weight was Jakub Kiel, but he was still stuck on that, slowing the ball down for the Western Province.
He must go 10. He must go 10. Go 10. Go 10. 9.
Well, it's a deep throw that hasn't worked this arm, securing the ball. Then the little dummy, very nearly away, Mnisi. Trinier, there's nobody directly behind this ruck, so Trinier had to virtually go on his own. The Lions players all lined very flat now. They're giving away a few penalties here. The pressure coming from the Western Province players. And I can't help but think, guys, you both,
John,
you know, played at international level. You've got to take your points.
They've got to take those 3 points, and they are lucky that they've got another chance here. There was almost a huge psychological moment. In the Currie Cup final, you've got to take your opportunities. When they present you, you have the opportunity to take those 3 points. Then you go for the line out, you throw bang over the top, you don't get your man, you turn over the ball.
Yeah, it's been interesting and very, indifferent decision making from the Western Province side. They've had the opportunity to put up some points, and that way you get your team, and you reward yourself for the effort that you've put in, because you got yourself inside the other team's half. So you want to get those points and make sure you keep on piling back. And now they're going to be starting chasing this game with no reason to.
As a picture of them. Jason on your side.
Well, there's butterflies swirling around in this young stomach, but he'll keep his head down, concentrate, and boots it over. Well done, Robert Dupria. Now, what can the Lions have defended deep inside the Western Province 22 there? Groom, well taken by Dupria. Good pass by Nick Groom through the right footed, predominantly right footed. Dupria onto the right situation. Borsa for the drop kick attempt.
That's why we play for. With the Golden Lions making sure they drop them back inside the 22. But look at this. How's that for ambition?
It was worth a pop, and you had the American football style throw from Andres. Could see it to get it center of the field for Marnitz Borsov. The game will resume with a 22 dropout, so no harm for the Golden Lions. It's worth an attempt.
Remember, a drop that misses and goes over the dead ball line is not conceived to be a scrum with a kicker. Kicked it. Trinier. Borsov. Kutsia. Robbie Kutsia. And Kutsia's outside. He's gained a bit of ground. You can see how quickly the forwards can gather.
We're just falling off our feet, guys. Come on.
Well, the Lions coaching hierarchy will not be happy with this penalty count. Penalties conceded now, 5-3. And the Lions penalties have all been in have all been in a kickable position. So Robert Dupree will kick again at goal.
The thing is, they've come in quick succession as well. So they break your momentum. They give momentum to Western Province. And now the importance of the kick gets highlighted. Robert Dupree, they declined the kick earlier. They kick it over now. They're at 6 points. They're that much closer. These players here all leaving their feet, diving in. And thus the penalty goes against them.
Well, a slight swing in the game. That's the wind factor at the stadium. So it'll come in and swirl around. Gabani Bobo will give you a little bit on the wind a little later. Tackles made now. 41 by the Lions. So it's suddenly the Lions who have had to make more tackles. They've missed 5 of those 41.
Yeah, there's no one contesting this flying. You've got a team.
That game to Rogers Miss. Gabani Bobo, what's the win factor?
Oh, yeah, it's swelling all the time, but then at that time it just died down for the young Robert Dupree. I think he was trying to overcompensate with that breeze because it's trying to blow his ball towards where he lent it on to. I think it just followed through. Make sure you go through your processes, kick your ball straight as hard as possible, and don't let the wind play any factor.
Oh, Nick Kloon, that's an unlucky mistake by the experienced scrum half. He was so keen to see what he could do with that ball.
And it's little things like this that can change the momentum. They've had a bevy of penalties going their way at Western Province, so they get that momentum. A little mistake like that can just change that momentum, get the Lions on the front foot, give them a bit of possession, give them territory.
So it's the bare facts are is that Borsoff has missed 2 penalties and Robert Dupree has missed 2.
Okay, that's 5-6.
Well, that's wonderful scrum by Province. Dupree, well, is that not a chance for a breakaway? And now he's kicked it out on the full. They heel a tight head and then they don't move the ball. In fact, I don't know whether the game's changed. Many years ago, you know, tight head, your scrum half broke,
you go, even the number 8, go 8-9, get them running because you had that advantage. There was a huge scrum from Western Province to force that tight head. Really blew that opportunity. The pressure of being a Currie Cup coach in a final, a youngster playing his first Currie Cup final. These are all the pressures that are going through these players' veins right now.
The throwing in has not been absolutely fabulous either. That time Whiteley secured the ball.
Too many bodies on the deck. Let's go.
Scrap. Good sack from Western Province. They're not giving him a chance for the line to set up a drive.
Too many bodies on the deck.
Just a sack for on Clay, making sure that the man doesn't get momentum. You can see there, Warren Whiteley winning that ball brilliantly. But like, look, the work now from the ground, straight to the ground. And in that way, we're not giving him the momentum to set up.
Now, Bugs, and if you think you can't take that down, as soon as the player comes to ground, you can take the guy who received that ball down to ground, but you've got to do it immediately. And you've got to take the player who's holding that ball. They did it very well there.
Let's go, Blue.
Province.
And it's a one-man sack. You can't have 2 players to tackle that man.
Well, the pressures of coaches on the right, Western Province, on the left, the Golden Lions.
You can see how much hair John Dobson has lost.
It's a common denominator, isn't it?
Exactly.
Okay, Crouch. Mind.
Now, let's see what happens with this scrum. Province will be very, very happy with the last one. Lions doing a little bit better so far. They've got it going. Whiteley on the front foot. Trinia, Manusi. Oh, beautifully handled by Trinia. Now Parker Smith. Always seems to make a yard through the tackle, as does Jaco Creel. Borsal, good set. Skorsal. Great tackle, Colby. Courageous tackle. Now Trinia. Well taken by Whiteley. Erasmus. Brilliant take by Smith. Sevens skills demonstrated there. Now it's Jansen van Rensburg. He's a big lad, as we often say. Now Trinia goes and ties his way over the line. Is it a try? Yes, it is. That's the Rashabenga towards the try. A little bit of pushing and shoving going on. Not like Warren Whiteley to get involved in a bit of a skirmish. Johnny Kotze is in there too. Lawrence Erasmus, all 2 meters of him.
Okay, come on, Rob. Listen, I don't think five needs to come in here and inflame the situation. Have a word to five. Thank you. What's that? Leave the pay alone on the deck.
Okay.
Leave him.
Please take it past me, please. Please take it past me. Support past the crew.
Which one? We were happy with it. We were happy.
John De Jong asking the ref to look for the forward pass.
Almost pleading with the referee to go up to Marius Jonker.
Gee, what a score again from the Lions. It was set up by this guy here, Nisi, the little offload that goes down, goes to ground, and pick up. Was that a knock on there from Ross Cronier? He gets it out wide, and then he does so well here. He holds that ball up. They all drift onto Mostert, and he just rides the tackle, gets his way over. Strong work by the little number nine.
And that's dragged to the left of the post. So we've now had five misses at goal by the two kickers.
Oh, this is all handbags at the end from that try. You can see that one is very happy. Lawrence Erasmus, one of those players, picking up and backing himself and taking the space was Ross Cronier. And they've been doing that the whole time, the Lions.
Dupria. Mostert. Good support from Riedinghuis, who's sort of like rushing around with a tower of light there. Colby. Well judged. Dupria. Oh, no.
Oh, the pressures of playing in a EPSA Curry Cup final. A shake of the head from John Stephen. Dobson.
There wasn't any hit. Come, let's go.
Kurt Coleman looking on.
Come, let's go. Kurt Coleman, who's already played in two finals.
Okay.
Anticipating what he's going to do with the ball before he even got into his hands. This is when you need all the senior players, maybe a few meetings for the leadership squad of the Western Province, just to bring the players together. Calm down. It's what the final is all about. He's supposed to enjoy the occasion and just live up to it, because this is what it's all about. You're happy about your preparation leading up to this game, and now it's all about execution.
And Bobes, you've got to clear your mind. You can't think too much about what just took place. Almost like a golfer walking to the next tee. Forget the bad shots. You've got to focus on what you got to do next.
Oh, it's all about the next task, isn't it, Bros?
Well, we've just had a stoppage in play for the second bit of attention to Stephen Kutsoff. But nothing wrong with the province scrumming.
Okay, there we go.
And it's scrum feet for the Golden Lions here. Western Province do not want to allow them to score another score before they go into in for half time.
Remember, steady, crap. Find.
Again, there's an interesting formation. Borsal straight behind the scrum, straight behind him is Andrew Skutsia. Janssen van Rensburg is to the left of the scrum, and Whitey takes it on the front foot. Alstad had to extend himself hugely to get across to the play. Now it's Jaco Kriel. Lay back for Cronje. Now Borsov. Erasmus. Good defense by Provence so far. Van Royen. Cronje. Manisi. Cronje. Kutsia. Robbie this time. Now Riedlinghuis is ready to take it. Little deft pass back to his halfback. Riedlinghuis to pick up again. Former head boy of Monos. And the Lions, with the pressure, win a penalty.
That's exactly what Western Province didn't want to happen. And if I was the Lions, you just take the 3 points. You just keep chipping away. You keep dragging that lead further and further out. I tell you, this shows you from the scrum. The Lions get a really good right shoulder here. They get the right shoulder. It gets Warren Whiteley on the front foot. Now, when you've got a number 8 with that amount of pace and skill, he's going to get you across the advantage line. He does so by about 10, 15 meters. A great target from which the Lions have to work from. Due to the scrum and then the job Warren Whiteley did.
Just enjoy the fact, Bros, they're playing more directly. They're doing more pick and goals as Western Province are trying to do the whole full coverage with the defensive line. And their pick and goals are working well for them.
Marnitz Borsov nails the conversion of the penalty. Remember, last week you kicked 9 out of 9 on this very ground. Smith again. The chase is good by Dylan Lates. Hasn't had too much of the ball this afternoon. The Province left winger, not the greatest clearance by Kutsia, but safely into touch with a minute and a fraction to go in the half.
Yeah, deviates a little bit from what they normally do. They try to get it to the midfield. They try and run it up with a forward player, and then they try to bring it back to the left to get it onto the left foot of Kutsia. They didn't quite have the angle this time, did the Lions, and they didn't get the distance.
Good chase up by Nizam Carr as well. Now this is good. Same go way. Forward ball for Province.
I'm going entry, you detached, entry over here. Entry.
So the number penalty four. Is given against Lorenz Erasmus. And
you detached over there, so I can't give you that one.
Juan de Jong walks over and points to the touchline, and Robert Dupria obliges.
Now, big decision. You saw a couple of the leaders came in there. Nick Groom, Juan de Jong to make that decision. They got some good purchase from this drive. There's one of the Lions players there. Just comes offside. Looks like Lorenz Erasmus. Crucial for Western Province if they take this and they go and score.
Well, it's been stolen by Whiteley. Robbie Kutsia. That's a carryover. Should be a 5 meter scrum to Western Province, and is. I think it was Warren Whiteley who tapped it down.
So brave again from the Lions to go up. When you go up, you take yourself out of the equation to stop the drive. Very brave from the Lions. Whiteley in the air. They win it. And they keep their line intact for the moment.
Okay, crouch.
Well, this should be the final play of the half, and will it be a vital one for Western Province? Look at that scrum. Just rock solid, and then they just get a little heave on the go. A little heave. Groom Dupria decides. Now Robert Dupria forces his way over. What a way to finish the half, because it's a half that hasn't really gone for the young fly half. But that will change the complexion completely.
Oh man, sport is so great. That's what it's all about. He's under pressure. He's under the cosh. He takes it to the line. He says, you know what, I'm just going to back myself. And in he goes. He gets the try. Boy, if any player needed that score, it was this man here, Robert Dupree. If any team needed it, Western Province needed it right there, right then, right now.
The conversion goes over the crossbar. So a very good seven-pointer for the young Western Province fly half. Yubani Bobo has made his way onto the field, and he will be just having a look with, he's with Ross Grenier.
Ross, a start that you guys were happy about, but at the end they come back with a try. Are you guys playing to what you guys wanted to do?
Yeah, I think we're doing well, keeping ball in hand. I think we can keep it a little bit more and some unnecessary kicks, but otherwise we're playing extremely well, keeping the tempo, and that's what we've got to do in the second half.
So keeping the tempo is what you're going to do in the second half. Best of luck with the halftime.
Thank you so much, Babs.
Cheers. It is 22 points to 10 for the Lions leading here. We will see you after this, see how the Lions will finish this off. All the Western Province come back.
Forty minutes to go in the domestic season of South African rugby, and in particular the Absa Curry Cup. And
what was your thoughts first from the first half?
No, it was good. You know, obviously you will be satisfied if you're leading. The disappointing thing was our discipline in our own half, Bob. So I think we, the last 10 minutes, 3-4 penalties that kept them in our half, and then eventually they scored, you know.
And then second half, the thought in the change rooms, what the boys supposed to do in the second half?
Yeah, we said we're going to reset because we expect a big tempo now from the province to come back. But if we can stick to our basics, sort out our scrums, line out, stick to that core of good possession, I think it will go well.
Best of luck for the rest of the season.
Thanks a lot.
Well, that core of possession applies to both sides as Marnus Vorsoff commences the final 40 minutes. Carr. Groom. Dupria. Kutsia.
Last.
Trinia. Mostert. Whitely up in close attention there. They'll go short side like that with Riedlin Hayes. Then away for Kutsia. Krunya. Erasmus. Whiteley. Mostert. Krunya. Borsoff. Oh, and there was a ball carrier. Came in the form of Quacha Smith. He was just waiting for somebody to put his hand up. Was Marnus Borsoff. The Lions' continuity into the 22-metre area of Western Province. And now their forwards get rumbling. Van Rooyen was in possession. Vosshoff. And now power away is Janssen van Rensburg. The young Waterkloof graduate. South African schools. Blue Bulls Craven Week. South African under 20. And now a try for the Lions in the Absa Curry Cup.
Gee, for me, this is very ominous from the Golden Lions. For Western Province, a lot of their defense were sitting on their heels. They were sitting back. They weren't coming forward. They were allowing this Lions team to get over the advantage line. Now, the Lions do very, very well at the quick play of the ball. They've got forwards from 1 to 8 that can all handle, and that gives them the go forward. This guy's so strong, 105 kgs. Concern now for Western Province. They've got to light the fire. They've got to come off that line in defense.
Just the Lions are not giving him any chances. But the one man who's been more embarrassed about this is Julian Redinghaus. He runs over his own tight head prop. Look at that from the outside centre.
Great running by the big and young outside centre. who has come into the game in the place of Stokkie's Hanekom, who's on the bench. Smith, Kutsia. It's a good kick away by the fullback. Stuart Berry trots into the Western Province half, exactly on the 10-meter line.
That's fantastic control by the Golden Lions, but this Currie Cup final now is all about Western Province. Can they pull themselves back into this game? Who is going to light that fire? Who is going to be the catalyst? Is it going to be one of these big guys up front that are going to set that fire alight? Because someone needs to step up, otherwise this final will slip away.
A shortened line out by Western Province. They've dropped a notchy out of the situation. Good take by Buerta. And Van Rooyen muscling his way across the mall there. They'll go flat. There's nobody deep. Groom. Fullmonk. Well taken by the left winger. Dylan Lates was up there. He just hasn't had the ball in hand as Lates. Now Borsoff running at the line. Beautiful hands above the tackle. Bit of over elaboration almost by the Lions there. The first move I thought was great. The second move, I'm not too sure.
They just won't die wondering what these Lions. They just want to be all about the skill. But what a take, keeping the eye on the ball. And then the turnaround to make sure if anything happens, he knocks it back onto his side. Good play from
Perfect
Anthony Fullmonk.
Perfect technique there by Anthony Fullmonk. He got his body in between the player and the ball. Should I say the advancing player.
What a shot from there. You can see the opportunities from either side and either back line.
They need a strong, solid scrum now to Western Province. They need to set that platform. They're desperate for points.
Bind. Set.
Well, again, that juggernaut. Both sides, one might say, juggernaut tax. Now Colby gets away from the first and had to dive into the 22-meter area of the Tuck province over to keep the momentum going. This is Nizam Khan. Good step in. Khan, he's well over. Surely that is a try for Nizam Khan.
Well, Blades, we call for it. They've delivered at Western Province. Yes, they have. A right smile from Sean Dobson. But that was very well done, and it was that drift pass from Robert Dupre to Colby that freed up the space, and then it was the strength of the number 8, Nizam Cole. He came on the angle, he sensed that there was space to the left, and he managed to get his way over. But it was a lovely drift ball for Colby to get the space out wide and put them into that position.
Robert Dupre is successful with the kick.
It's all about the outside arc that he takes on Howard Nisi. You can see the pace.
So an amazing game,
line.
Just when you think they are going to run away with it, Bobs, they go and score a try like this.
Oh, what good hands from Notcher. Just the way to spot the player, shooting out of line and then picking up the great line on Nizam Khan. This is Robin Kutia being served for Michael Marks.
So the coach is starting to show their hands already. 7 minutes into the second half and Malcolm Marks is on the park. Now it's De Jong who boots it away. Yep. Borsoff is there. Kutsia in midfield. Could see her under a little bit of pressure there from Buerta, Cronier, Borsov looked on the inside. There wasn't a runner that time. Now way for Erasmus. Cronier, Fulman, good angle run by the left winger.
Turn up was good.
Good pick up by Manisi. Now it's Marks. He really is an immensely powerful young man, Malcolm Marks. Van Rooyen. Ooh, little burst through the gap by the loose end. Now it's Kutsia. The Lions lying quite flat at the moment. Only forwards as the first receivers. But it goes for Borsoff wider. Now Manisi. Desperate to grab on the ball there by Nizam Khan.
Hey,
away by Colby for Groom. Now Kutsoff. Went to ground almost before Warren Whiteley tackled him. Bongi and Benambi who tried to make some ground there. Dupria, now De Jong. Little inside outside, creates space for Carr. Now it's Kotsa. Groom, Province building up quite nicely here. Away for Sinatra. He's got plenty of pace. Has Sinatra now in Benambi. Sinatra again. Dupria. Elstadt. Solid defense by Jacques Van Rooyen. Groom, Dupria. De Jong took his eyes off it. Pressure from Janssen van Rensburg. Referee said backwards. We'll charge forward by Buerta, by Klein, in fact it was.
Who's that?
Groom. Well, well defended by Cronier. Borsoff. Just made enough ground there, Borsoff, to get one or two of his players in behind the ball.
Who's that?
Whiteley saying go left. We'll boot it downfield. Now it's Nick Groom who concentrates on that one. Colby, this is danger for the Golden Lions. Colby couldn't find a running Groom. Player. Worked out by Jean Klein then. Groom on the territorial search. And that is rolling and rolling. Is it on the line? Is out.
That was the right call from Nick Groom. He needed to look for a little bit of territory. Didn't get the bounce of the ball, but he spotted that there was acres of space open out wide. And looks like it'll be his last act of this EFSA Currie Cup final for 2015. He's going to depart. And Jana Vermaak, a very experienced Jana Vermaak. He played so many seasons here for the Lions. Will come on. And he is bound to have an impact.
Well, Jana Vermaak, who plays in his, wins his 94th cap today, played in one final for the Lions, as Warren Brosnahan mentioned, back in 2007. 8 years ago, Bobs.
8 years ago he played, and now he's back here. He's going to show a bit of experience. You saw the impact that he had in the semi-final. He was outstanding the way he came back. He scored the final try that took a game away from the Bulls. To settle the players down. I guess that's what they brought him here for. All that experience. Good player to have on the pitch.
Well, the crowd enjoying this early-ish mid-afternoon sunshine here. The crowd, bit of cloud starting to form, but otherwise a very warm day on the Highveld.
Yeah, it's Wilco Lowe in the number three jersey. He seems to lose his feet.
Just a slip. Yeah, let's move across.
Yeah, it's scrum time. Feet are very far back. Out they slip, and down it goes.
So if you're going to slip.
Well, Wilco Lowe, who grew up in the Boerland at Droste and played, then went to the Bulls, just 21. He turned 21 in July.
He He's up against Jacques van Rooyen, who's had a good game this
okay,
afternoon.
Bind. Set.
Looks like Ollie Kebbell will also come onto the park now. Can they get a second shot? That should come Whiteley's way. Manisi breaks that first tackle. Trunier again. Manisi, was that offside? The referee says continue. Trunier again, away for Riedlinghuis. Kutsia, then for Munk. Oh, well, there's a whole host of errors here. Bongi and Benambi in some discomfort there. On comes Kurt Coleman. Well, Warren Brosnahan and I were discussing the halftime substitution maybe of Robert Dupriel, but John Dobson decided against it, and now Kurt Coleman comes on. He's played in two finals before, so this will be his third final.
This is some of the things that Robert Dupriel would probably not be wanting to look at again on the video after this.
He won't be sending this highlight reel to his manager.
But it's what pressure does to a player. But then he was able to rise above it and get in for a vital score on the halftime hooter. Stephen Kitsoff is left as well. Ollie Kebbell is on.
Yeah, Ron Jay has gone on for the Golden Lions at loose head.
So Jacques van Rooyen can be happy with his afternoon. Robbie Kutsia also has been substituted by Malcolm Marks. Ruan Dreyer, as Bobs was saying, at loose head.
Scrum's going down the far side with Ollie Kebbell and Julian Riedlinghuis. The ref is only going to allow them to put that ball in once the scrum is square and stable and there's no movement.
Well, Ollie probably got a bit of advice from his dad, Guy, who played in four finals.
The Bull Kebbell, who was an immense force in that front row. For the Sharks in the 90s.
Early engaged by the Lions. Carr. Whiteley makes the tackle. For Mark. Coleman. The two new guys on the park. Now, will that go over the dead ball line? Then if Foreman needs to go to it quickly. No, well, the ball's away from the dead ball line. You have to lie down to pick that up whilst it's still moving.
Yeah, that'll be an interesting call from him. But you're right, you always are trying to make sure that you get to the ball as quick as possible so you can open up your options for yourself. The Lions will be happy to slow the ball down here.
Julian Riedlinghuis is coming back to the 22 pretty slowly. Borsuk will look for territory. Lates. Coleman. Not a bad little bit of footwork there by Dylan Lates. Now Coleman obviously has been told to get out there and look for territory. Great fielding by Marnitz Borsoff and by Cheslin Colby. Has this ability to accelerate away. That was a brilliant tackle by Jaco Kriel. Kunya comes away. Now Erasmus. The pass away is gathered by Johnny Kotsa. Now the Lions under pressure here. Hard Manisi. Lovely dummy by him. Takes on the province defenders. And driving defense it was too by province. So the Lions under pressure. But there was a knock on there.
Yep, we're going to check the tackle. Someone. Okay, what do you have?
After the player released the ball.
Okay, Tamo. Okay.
Jason, have you got a number for me?
Marius, are you there?
Yeah, I got you.
We just want to check a possible dangerous tackle round about halfway line by number 11. By number 5, blue, please.
Number 5, blue, good.
Yep.
So the jury is out on Ruan Buerta. Well, it wasn't 5, it was 17.
Oh, that's Ollie Kebble.
Well, I think it's strictly according to the laws that could be a yellow card.
Yeah, that is above horizontal by the law.
Can you hear me, Marius? Sorry.
Yeah, just give us a time.
I think now it's all about.
Erasmus almost launches himself up into the air, but it's how Kebble drops him down which is the problem.
Rasta, I've got a decision for you.
Yes, Marius.
We're looking at number 17, blue. From what we can see, the red player sort of jumped into the tackle. However, 17, blue, did not bring that player down to the ground safely.
Yep, I agree. So I'm going to go with a penalty only against number 17, blue.
I'm happy with that, yeah.
Thank you. 17.
I think that's well handled, but well GMO'd by Marius Jonker and
you've got to bring him down safely.
Rasta Rashivenga, you know, if you go and give a yellow card.
Totally agree with you.
Yeah. Well done.
Yeah, it's well officiated that. I guess sense prevailed at the end. No malice was taken into anything, but good call from the officials up here.
And I think this is a good call from the Golden Lions as well. There's been a period of momentum from Western Province. They've got an opportunity here just to take a shot at 3 points, and they may as well take it.
Yeah, it's a big deficit for Western Province to chase. And now they're just making sure that they drill that into their head.
Well, they lead by, what 12, have we got, 12 at the moment.
15.
15 means you've got to score twice. No, 3 times.
Two converted tries with the penalty.
It's just the two paces. He's given it a hefty kick. Fabulous kick.
Unbelievable. Monats Boshoff, you miss all those other kicks, but you get the tough one. You nail it, you hit it. And that stretches that lead to 15. Superb kick by Marnitz Boshoff.
You can see already Fonsal is on for Clayton on the lock for Western Province.
Okay, let's go. Time back on.
And you can see there Kotza is replaced by Hugh Jones, who comes on at the inside center for Western Province too.
Parker Smith, good seer, good chase up by Dylan Lates. Trunia Boshoff, a good chase up there by Yano for Mark. And so Johnny Kotza comes off the field, substitute of plenty now. John Klein is also off.
Yeah, fantastic, isn't it? The Bok game coming up against the All Blacks later. We've got Lions supporters. They've all dressed up, and Western Province did well there. They had a good kick chase. They took the Lions out of their structure from kick receipt. Well done there by Western Province.
Good line out play there by Chris Van Sale. Hugh Jones is the one who replaced Johnny Kotza. All a bit of a scramble at the moment, and penalty gain the way of Western Province. Looked like against Julian Riedlinghuis.
Offensive 18. Okay. Sorry. I thought you said Coles. 18 white, Bernard.
So Kurt Coleman will go for touch as we move close to the final quarter of the game.
Where's 18?
Again, a big call from Western just Province declining their kick at goal to get themselves moving forward.
Chris Van Sale, who is on the park in the number 18 jersey, the brother of Anton Van Sale, who was here for a number of seasons. Also, their dad played for Natal, Mike Van Sale. And a good sack by the Lions there, with the Province on the front foot now as they get it away. By their loose forwards now for Mark, will get it to Coleman. Little switch there with Jones.
Good tackle by Van Rensburg.
For Mark, Coleman. Again coming for the halfback. Good hands there by Kevill. For Mark Coleman. Oh, it's a telling tackle there by Janssen van Rensburg. Still Province controlling this ball well and battering away up to the 5 meter line. Not sure.
Keenout's good.
Keenout's good. Now Coleman. They've got a little bit of space here. Jones. And Sinatra couldn't hold on. Oh. Did he get a hand to it? It looked like he might have, but it might just have overextended the top try scorer in the Province team.
Okay, White, we've got an option. Knock into touch option.
They've got the option here. That drift ball from Hugh Jones, just asking too much of Sinatra. He couldn't get his hand out there.
Lost forward.
Drifting left to right. I mean, right to left was Sinatra. Unable to catch it.
What an opportunity missed there by Western Province. He feels sometimes maybe keeping the ball in hand. There was Jean de Jong inside him there, Hugh Jones. Maybe he could have used those hands, and in that extra pair of hands, maybe could have created an opportunity for Sinatra. Much more simpler pass, but at the end, opportunity for the finisher. He should have finished that.
Yeah, and they upped the physicality to the Western Province there. They had some really physical carries. One in particular from Elster. It was good.
Okay, Crouch. Find. Set.
Great scrum by Western Province. Superb scrum. Wins them the penalty. But they're chasing the game a little bit now. 32-17. You go for the line out and then you don't score. Creates a little doubt in your mind. Number 22 there, Hugh Jones, a graduate of Millfield in England. The great Gareth Edwards and JPR Williams went there.
And he's highly rated by Coach John Dobson, who says he'll go on to play international rugby. Gee, this is a sight that you do not see very often. The Lions scrum getting absolutely monstered, fragmented, broken up, and drilled.
It's a way that they isolated Julian Redinghuis there with Ollie Kebble.
But again, the Lions look for the sack now. The penalty advantage, not here. Great try, Province. They're not out of it yet.
Gee, Bobes, are we sensing something here from Western Province? They've upped the physical ante. They've got a lot more physical, more direct. Then they get the big scrum, they get the tight end, they get the penalty, and now they've shown physicality on the drive. This is brilliant stuff. It goes to Buerta, straight to the back to Notchi. He gets in the boots of this drive. They get good depth, there's good communication, and there's no stopping it. It's like a runaway train. They get the try. They're back in this game.
Oh, you can see it's all about the numbers on the feet. For Western Province, they carry on. You can see a whole of the pack of the Lions on the floor. What a try for Western Province. They're just 10 points away now with the conversion to come.
Well, we say conversion to come. All these kicks now become absolutely vital for both sides. Kurt Coleman coming on as the replacement for Robert Dupuy. Can he do the job for his team? Skosan came flying out of the blocks. Good kick, Kurt Coleman.
What a good set here. Go to the money ball, man. Walter, look at the numbers now of the Lions forwards on the floor and the Western Province staying up on their feet. All of that momentum for Notcha just to get over for their third try of the game.
Yeah, and it all looked a bit too simple, didn't it? Very easy.
The Lions wouldn't be happy with that stemming of the drive. There are only one or two guys that committed themselves.
Coleman committed to catching that kickoff. Good play by the fly half, because the Nizam car looked like he wanted to take it. But it was great work. First of all, Ruan Buerta, who fought the line out extremely well, powerfully, one might say. And then that set it up for the rest of the province forwards. The crowd trying to get a wave on the go, taken by Erasmus, Cronier, Creel. They've watched Creel very closely, and Quacha Smith, for that matter, the Western Province. Cronier, now it's with Marks. Maybe they haven't heard too much about Malcolm Marks, who downs over the advantage line. Now Lawrence Erasmus. When he's in the clear, Lawrence Erasmus, a difficult player to stop. Good ducking by Cronier. Foreman moves to half-back. Not too many back-line runners out there. Erasmus. The one thing from the Lions' point of view, it uses up time and territory. Could see it from full-back, looking for work. Cronier, now Creel. Gets rid of that notch it was. Now into the Western Province 22-metre area. Borsoff hasn't got a runner, goes on the kick. And, very nearly coming away with it there.
He caught it.
Was unreal catching there by Cheslin Colby, who I think might have done himself a bit of damage. Now Coleman, where is that? A runner there, and they found good ground here, Western Province. Although it will be a Lions throw-in, that's good territory. Two of the Province players, though, are down.
How is this?
The acrobatic skill by Colby to have the sense of where his body was, where the ball was, to go through all that. That is unbelievable.
Time off, please.
I know he's holding his back, but my gosh, Cheslin Colby. The Warren, demonstration of skill that you've just given us.
Yep. Warren Brosnan, what about the neck flick just to place the ball back? This man can jump around. He's been manhandled the whole time, but look at that comeback. Look at that skill from the young player.
And I tell you, this crowd is coming alive as well. They're talking, they're speaking. It's all about the EFSA Curry Cup final.
Oh, the Western Province fans are up. Their tails are up. Now they're trying to chase it. You see the 44,000 people out here, 183, just being blessed with skills and what high quality it is, this Curry Cup final.
Well, high quality, high tension. We've got Oli Kebble down, so Stephen Kutsoff is allowed to warm up and come on as a replacement front row. Cheslin Colby is still in some discomfort with his back. That wonderful bit of athleticism, unfortunately, has ended with him holding his back very gingerly. Has it cooled down a bit, Bob?
Oh, it has cooled down. There's not much sun to talk about. There's a bit of an overcast, a bit of clouds, but the fans are having a good time. It's unbelievable.
Oli Kebble is okay. Malcolm Marks will throw. Warren Whiteley receives. Taken by Mostert eventually.
Last three.
Kutsia, again a good chase by Jano for Mark.
And that's a positive result for Western Province. They competed line out time, they harass, they apply pressure on Kutsia. They get the line out feed just outside that 22.
Michael Willemsen now with the throw, the former Grey High School in PE boy. Won by Wakey, taken by Trinier, beautifully, now Fulman. Still inside the lines, 22. Away now by Borsa. Finds Jiedling Heiss. We'd lay back by the tight end. Trinier. Dreyer. Fulman is back. Decides to do that and follows a good touch. That's a really good kick by Anthony Fulman, who comes racing up to prevent the quick throw-in by Dylan Lates.
Gavani Bobo, talk us through this. We've had two really good kicks now. One from Kurt Coleman. We saw him, he got field position. And then this one here from Fulman.
Look at the technique of keeping his head still and then a drop and keeping his eyes on to the ball and using his left foot with the touchline. Done very well for Anthony Fulman.
Robin's not wasting time in setting up the ball from the line-out. Carr, not Shea, then Coleman is grounded by Janssen van Rensburg. De Jong. And a friendly bounce for Anthony Fulman. Can he do it again?
Oh, he does.
Come out wide.
Kurt Coleman is back. Cheslin Colby, what will he do now? Yeah, well, decides to do that because he's still a bit gingerly holding the back of his.
Well, I tell you, it wasn't a bad kick from Cheslin Colby.
Anyone would be happy with that. Braz has cleared the whole half of his height, got his side into the opposition's half, so the forwards are very happy because they were just standing there.
Four white sub.
Well, there's a sub coming on where Fabian Boysen will come on for Lawrence Erasmus. Gets a huge ovation from the home crowd.
Gee, I reckon he's been immense as Lawrence Erasmus. He's competed a lot outside and he's given him a lot of go forward.
I'll be surprised if he doesn't win the fight of the season for this Golden Lions pack. He's put players like Emi Lusasani onto the bench. He's come on for Martin Miller and he's taken his chance as the young man.
Fabian Boysen in the middle of the line-out now. Malcolm Marks with the throw. Boysen the dummy. Up goes Borstert. It was Chris Van Sale who tried to get a hand in the way there. Now Yaku Kriol. Difficult to pick at the man of the match here because everybody's pulled their weight. Warren Whiteley being one of them. Ross Cronier another. This is Malcolm Marks. Howard Manisi in support. Boysen. Now a chance here for Fulman. Can't get away from Buerta. Oh, Riedland has pounds into the ruck. And Cronier is held up well by Noche. Malcolm Marks again. Always makes a meter or two. Quickly by Manisi. Whiteley with Sinatra. Very nearly came away with it again. The whistle's gone. And now the players realize that John De Jong thought he might have been away. But one of the players is down and looking really uncomfortable.
It's Nizam Carr.
Nizam Carr is one of them.
Yeah, Nizam Carr.
Also, Kurt Coleman is down on his knees. But Nizam Carr looks the worst for wear.
Yeah, he does. It looks like as if he might have a stinger. Took a tough tackle there. That's Kurt Coleman who's having taking a knee. But his injuries are starting to come on now.
This is the contribution that Nizam Carr has made. Such a physical player. Made his test debut last year against Italy. He's become one of the real leaders of this Western Province team. He provides good go forward. He's got some physicality. He likes to tackle. And he's very safe with that ball in his hands as Nizam Carr. He gets in there for the try. He's had a good game. And hopefully he will continue.
Meanwhile, Quagga Smith has come on to be replaced by Stefan de Witt. So all four replacement forwards on the field for the Golden Lions. Now Storky Sanakom will come on. Janssen van Rensburg gets a big cheer as well from the packed stands in the season ticket holders.
Is that a great game? The 21-year-old centre was looking forward to this, but nervous before speaking to him. But he took his chances, ran hard, tackled like a demon. Good work from a junior player.
Strong scrum by the Lions. Trunier, Bosoff, Manisi. Great tackle by Vermaak. Trunier again. Finds De Wit, Steph De Wit, who's also one of those strong flank forwards. Bosoff. Vermaak. Well held by Leitz. Bosoff again. Help from Kutsia.
Advantage. Advantage.
Advantage to the Lions.
Came off his hand.
With the knock-on.
A
small little knock-on from Yuri van Vuren.
Yuri van Vuren, who's on the in the bright blue scrum cap, the former Oakdale learner.
It's all just a little bit lateral there from the Lions. They never really committed any of the defence of Western Province, and they get away with a little knock-on there from Western Province as they try to play the ball on the ground. So they'll get that scrum feed again, but sure. Less than 9 minutes to go for the season for 2015. Everything to play for between these two teams. They're separated by 8 points. Who's going to be the EFSA Currie Cup final champion?
Well, Rasta Rashivenga, Dave's 29, the youngest ever to referee a Currie Cup final. What a record he's got. At just the tender age of 29 as a referee. Deliberate wheel, I think that was, Bobs. Well, Braz, maybe you can give comment. I think it was for the deliberate wheel.
Yeah, deliberate wheel. I went around the corner. Well, the Golden Lions will gratefully accept it. They'll drill this down. Play will resume and within, deep into the 22 of the Western Province. It's going to be a really good attacking opportunity now for the Golden Lions. They walk slowly towards this line out.
All the replacements on for Western Province. Still Jaco van der Walt and Sampi Mesquite available for Johan Ackerman. Taken by Jaco Creel. Trying to get them all going, but the other thing is it's using up valuable time. The crowd are out of their chairs now. Willing their team on way by Trunier. Bosoff, Manisi. Manisi dropped it.
What a tackle.
But the referee will go back. There's another decision, I think, to be made by Mr. Rashivenga, and it's a penalty to the Lions. A Lions player down. Oh, looks like Julian Riedlinghuis may be down, and a Province player.
Oh, it's Will Keller.
Yeah, it is Julian Riedlinghuis.
Come on, it's Bosoff. Just looks so good when he takes that ball to the line in that manner. Offloads, get his centre, Howard Anisi. Running into space, a pity Adonisi couldn't hold on to that ball. Vokala, he looks like he's got a stinger that you referred to earlier, Gobani.
Yeah, he does, and Kitsoff is back again. His job is never done as a front rower. It just shows you, with the 22-man squads that you get for Currie Cup, you don't have the two props on the bench, so if you start, you're bound to come back again. That's why Jacques Van Rooyen is back on for...
He looks very groggy.
Riedlinghuis.
Riedlinghuis.
Come back on.
Well, he looks like he's got a bit of a shine, but he's had an outstanding game, Julian Riedlinghuis.
What a shift he's put on. 73 minutes with a tight end. Running up and down, cleaning rucks, scrumming, mauling. Good work from Julian Riedlinghuis.
Well, I just stood up in my commentary position here as did Warren Brosnihan and Bosoff. Powered that ball into the stands. A brilliant take by one of the spectators.
Stolen.
Well stolen by Buerta for Mark Coleman. Now they're running the ball inside their own in-goal area.
Pace is out here.
Colby is on the run, and well, now goes to Mark and the cross. So this could be a wonderful try for Mark. Oh, that might have been knocked on. It was knocked on. What a wonderful run out by Western Province. Cheslin Colby has stayed down again, but look at this, Bros.
Unbelievable stuff. That was from deep within their own end goal area. Sinatra and then off to Yana for Mark. They'll knock on there from Jean de Jong, but the Province, thanks, they're Jackson. Not going to die. They're going to ask questions. They're going to continue. They're going to fight for that, to get that final.
No, they really need to get that points down. But I love the ambition. You're right, Warren. They won't die wondering. They're always trying to make sure that they push themselves. And there's an opportunity. Yes, they are down by 8 points. But what a chance.
That's what it's all about, Kavani.
Oh, sitting right in front of me. It's glorious, this. Unbelievable. And the crowd has just lived up to it.
Over 120 years old, Trunia. Was that on the full? No, it wasn't. And Jason Yupta down the far side as the referee's assistant runs into the Western Province half.
Scrumming in.
Again.
Shoulder.
Warren Whiteley does well. The little offload and the chip just falls inside. Yes, it does. From Ross Cronier. Ross Cronier has had a really good game for the Lions.
Use it!
Now it's with Van Vuren. Coleman. Colby.
Advantage. Rack was there and he went in late. Rack was there.
Mark will go quickly.
You can't go over a collapsed rack. Hands.
3.5 minutes to go.
Oh, good tackle there from Nisi, but it went above the shoulders. That's what was a high tackle at the end, but just making sure that the nimble footed Cheslin Colby doesn't get away with it.
But from here, Blades. Western Province have to go and score if they want to have anything to do with this Currie Cup final for 2015.
Another throw by Michael Willems, so taken well by Buerta. Coleman, not Shea. Hugh Jones to Young. Line of defenders out, but in midfield they've got a lock and a front rank up. Mostert is calling for reinforcements for Mark Coleman. Now Kevill, away for Jones, holding on for dear life. There was Ross Cronier, serious contender for man of the match, worked out by Buerta. It was Coleman's little pass.
Is
that one? Counter ruck is good. Away goes Mostert, another contender for man of the match. Ruan Dreyer keeps it tight. Van Ruyen goes in. Cronier. Kutsia decides to go on the run and makes a few meters. Now can the Lions forwards get there quickly enough? Cronier, Mostert, Borsov gets it behind Colby. It's on the bounce. Brilliant bounce for them. Colby goes. Skusan holds up intelligently. Now Sinatra tracks on the pace. Very nearly tackled there by Stokis Hanakom. Slowed down enough, I think, for the other Lions players to get there. Lions at the Province have got to keep the ball in hand. Lakes tries to do something. They can't kick it away unless it's to kick and regain. Now Ollie Kevill up against Fulmer. Jones is in there too.
Ball's available, yeah, it's available. Last week,
the ball 21. Is available for Vermark. Has to dig quite deep for it. Van Vuren. First one tackle, good little bit of gaining ground there. off a mark. Was Hanekom onside? No, says the referee. Penalty goes the way of Province. Less than a minute to go. Province have to score twice.
I just want to check something with Jude. I can't hear carefully. Time off. Yes, Jude.
Not the right initial penalty. I think you need to check the clean out from 18 blues to whether he's used a shoulder or arm. Stop.
With Marius, yeah. Okay. Marius, are you there?
Yeah, I got that. I'm moving with you.
Okay, thank you.
So 18 blue is Chris Van Sale.
Well, this is the 18 blue. You can see that Chris Van Sale going into the shoulder onto Warren Whiteley from the side. Not coming from the last man's feet, but look at that. It's coming in from the side. That's why that there was a flag out from Stuart Barry. This is what we, at the moment, it's the first angle, not bound to anyone, coming into a mall and taking off. We call that a chip shot.
Well, Kurt Coleman has already placed the ball for the penalty for Western Province.
Let's look at the angle
he's
from the other side, Morris.
Back, so the decision to be made.
He binds on the plane.
Still a decision. They might ruin all those mistakes that we needed. Never take those penalty kicks from the first half. Now, can you imagine how much it will be in the game now? That's what we're looking at.
Well, decision time for Marius Jonker.
Stewie, which one are you looking at? That's the only one we've got that we're looking at now.
It was a breakdown here,
right,
Marius.
Will we have a look?
Yep.
This is the one he's looking for.
Yep, this one.
Gary leading with the shoulder, number 18. So, you see with those two involvements that Chris Van Sale had.
Okay, Rasta.
Yes, Maurice.
I have a decision for you. That was number 18, okay. Blue, with a dangerous clean out.
Yeah, I agree.
And 18, do you want my recommendation?
Okay, Maurice, I'm going to give a penalty only against number 18, Blue. I'm going to reverse the previous penalty for an offside penalty. Okay, you happy with that, Maurice?
Rasta, I think we need to reconsider that action by 18, Blue. I think it's more than a penalty.
You think it's more serious?
Correct.
Okay, time off, please.
Well, this will be a yellow card for Chris Van Sale. But 18. It does mean that...
Yeah, I agree with you.
Frankly,
thank
with
you.
Less
yellow.
Than a minute to go.
Two dangerous cleanups at the breakdown. This is your second dangerous cleanup. So I'm going to penalise you and you're going to get
well, if Province had any chance of winning this game, they would have had to have kicked that goal and then come away and scored another try at least.
Yeah, it had to be converted for that to win it because they're 8 points behind. But look at this, look at the crowd, seconds going down the clock here, sense of time for Western Province going down. But look at the jubilation of the stadium, just cheering every kick, every run that Golden Lions are making. I can see that even the extra staff here is down, the wives and girlfriends are down already waiting and anticipating the final whistle.
Well, they would have looked up at the stadium clock and know that there are less than 20 seconds to go. The big thing is, will they hoot to go immediately? They really need to just win the possession. Up goes the captain. The flags are waving. And Ross Pernier gets it back to Skosar, who boots it into the crowd, boots it up into road wide, and the celebrations begin. Well, the this situation is absolute pandemonium, Bobs.
It is pandemonium, but what about the Golden Lions? Perfect season, unbeaten, and that is going to be the feeling for the Western Province on their knees, taking off the higher path for the contribution that they gave into this game. But what a triumph for the Golden Lions. What good work from the management, well deserved from the Lions.
Well, of course, they will be very happy. Unbeaten, they scored 4 tries, 2 provinces, 3, and it was a really strange kicking performance from both the firehouse initially. They then came back cold and kicked a good conversion. Vossoff kicked his final 3 kicks on the Lions. No wonder, are so delighted. So that win for them by 8 points.
Yeah, we're champs!
A faultless, flawless season for the Golden Lions. Disappointment for the likes of Sonata and Western Province, who really made a big game of this afternoon. But ultimately, I think the Lions' cohesion was too much. They moved the ball around brilliantly. They've done it all season. Jaco van der Walt didn't get onto the park this afternoon, but he still will be a member of the team celebrating the winning of the Absa Curry Cup for 2015. You can see the big crowd there in the season ticket holders. They haven't moved at all. Crowd on the far side, not absolutely packed on the far side. We saw slightly over 44,000 people here this afternoon. Rudolf Strohle said they had sold 38,000 tickets, and so the Lions supporters, the faithful Lions supporters, one has to say, are finally rewarded with a Curry Cup title, and the Curry Cup trophy will be.
Call it me, lads.
I just reckon a brew, bro.
A brew, bro?
No, a brew, bro.
A brew, bro.
A brew.
A beer.
A bear?
A beer.
A beer.
I love 3 LMPs, mate.
World Cup Weekly, live Monday, Sky Sport 1.